feel it in his flow. Holy Spirit, move. 'Cause when you have your way, something has to break. Tear down every lie, set the wrong thing right. 'Cause when you have your way, something has to break. Something has to break. Right now in your name, something has to break. Something has to break. Hey, right now in your name, something has to break. Oh, I believe you'll get me to it. I believe you'll lead me through it. I believe that you will do it right now. Something has
Galatians chapter 6 verse 9 in the King James says, and let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. And let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. I want to read the same scriptures in the TPT, if I could, real quickly. The Bible says, and don't allow yourselves to be weary or disheartened in planting good seeds. For the season of reaping the wonderful harvest you have planted is coming. Wow. Ain't that a powerful scripture? Can I read it to you one more time? If they could bring it back to me just one more time. And don't allow yourselves to be weary or disheartened in planting good seeds. For the season of reaping the wonderful harvest you've planted is coming. I want you to turn to someone close by and say, mine is on its way. Come on, my harvest is on its way. It was so funny, and I hope this is okay, but Jonathan and Ty are trying to become parents, right? And so this, we teased them about triplets and stuff, and so this morning I sent him over a picture of these three little babies, and the one had on a shirt said, I was planned. The second one said, I wasn't. And the third one said, me neither. But when you plant a seed, you can expect a harvest. Hello? Now, I want you to hear it again. The season of reaping, the wonderful harvest you've planted is coming. The season of reaping, the wonderful, everybody say wonderful. It's not just going to be a regular harvest. It's not going to be the same old, same old. I want you to know that God is making you a promise on this last day of January that there is a wonderful harvest coming. You have planted it. He's watered it. The Holy Spirit's done this thing. And guess what? You are going to receive it in Jesus' name. Matthew chapter 6 says, when you give, when you pray, when you fast. When you pray, when you give, when you fast. The Bible didn't ask if you give, if you pray, if you fast. The Bible just simply says, when ye give, when you pray, when you fast, you can expect a harvest. Every one of you that has participated in the pursuit this month, no matter what you've done, you will receive a harvest for what you have given, what you have given up, and what you have prayed for. It will come to pass in the name of Jesus Christ. All of these are seed planting endeavors that takes time and measure of endurance. We all understand that our God is a God of miracles. Our God is the God of suddenly. Our God is one that can just speak and it's done. But you know what? There are miracles and then there are healings. A miracle is something that God does instantaneously. A healing is something that takes place over time. Endurance is synonymous with biblical faith because faith waits. Faith perseveres. Faith sustains. Faith believes into overtime. And faith never gives up. Faith never gives up. I don't care how sick you are today. You that are watching online, you may be in a hospital. Maybe they haven't given you much time. I want you to know, as long as there's faith on the inside of you, as long as there's a breath on the inside of you, you never give up, never give up, never give up. Because sometimes it just takes holding on just a little bit longer. Through giving, praying, fasting, we are planting by faith the seeds of our future reality. Oh, listen to me. Through giving, praying, and fasting, we are planting by faith of what our future reality is going to be. You say, Pastor, what's my tomorrow going to look like? What kind of faith do you have? What have you prayed for? Have you fasted? Have you given? Because giving, praying, and fasting are all planting seeds for a tomorrow reality. If I never pray, if I never fast, if I never give, guess what? Then I can't be expecting nothing tomorrow. I will get whatever life gives me. I will get whatever's dealt to me. But if my faith is in the Lord Jesus Christ and I'm doing these things that he's told me to do, no matter what life has dealt me, the Holy Spirit will say, stop right there. Don't touch my child. I believe that my faith, my giving, and my prayer can stop cancer from coming into my body. Can stop COVID from taking me out. It can stop all kinds of things. By when I pray and I give and I fast, I am resisting the devil out of my house, off of my family, off of my marriage. Why would you want to try to do it by yourself? The statistics are not well. Are you hearing me? When you try to do it by yourself, the statistics are not good. I would much rather to lean upon the Lord Jesus Christ and to lean upon his word. As we wait, pray, and worship, the Holy Spirit is going to water the seed. And after the Holy Spirit waters the seed, then God's going to bring forth miracles into our lives. The key component to the process is clearly stated in the King James Version of Galatians chapter 9, verse number 6, where it says, we shall reap if we faint not. We shall reap if we faint not. That Greek word for faint means to relax, to weaken, or loosen the grip, to let go. We shall reap if we faint not, if we don't get too relaxed, if we don't get too weak, if we fail to hold on to what God has promised us. It's quiet in here this morning, and I'm thankful because it lets me know that you're allowing this word to get down into your spirit. Amen? I don't care what happens in this world. Ty said it a while ago. The bottom line is it all ended yesterday. I just love the saying. It's one of my favorite. Yesterday ended last night at midnight. Today is a new day. Tomorrow is a new month. I'm not going to spend all of 2021 talking about what the devil did in 2020. I just want you to know that there's a great harvest coming. That there's a great harvest coming. That God wants to bless your home. God wants to bless your business. God wants to pour blessings upon everybody in this house. Chris, God did not bring you this far to let you down. The devil is a liar. And this whole church is praying right now that the same God that's touched you in times past is the same God that's going to touch you and deliver you now. Somebody shout yes. Somebody shout yes. Yes. Sometimes we give up too early. Sometimes we throw the towel in too early. Sometimes we let go. We loosen our grip way too early. Let me close with sharing this with you. The key to not giving up in the middle of the battle is simply this. Do not do battle alone. Woo. The key to not giving up is not to do battle alone. Chief Brian, learn to call for backup. I'm going to be honest with y'all. I love cop shows. Sometimes I'll be sitting at home watching a cop show and, you know, drugs is involved or trafficking's involved, something is involved, and sometimes I'll fall off asleep And while I'm sitting in my chair sound asleep, I'm in blue. I'm like walking tall. I got a stick in my hand. I'm like Clint Eastwood. I got a big old gun about that long. You ever watch a show and fall asleep, and somehow when you fall asleep, you put yourself in that movie, in that show? Y'all would be shocked how many bad people I've caught in my lifetime. You ought to see me in the movies. Right now, I can't hardly bend over and tie my shoes, but in the movies, I'm kicking everybody's butt. I'm wiping everybody out. Bruce Lee ain't got nothing on me. But listen, in life, you got to learn to call for backup. In 1 Samuel chapter 15, we can see from David's battle that some days we fight for others, and other days we need someone to fight for us. Hear me. If you miss this, you're going to miss something that you can hold on to for the rest of your life. I said, in battle, some days we fight for others. And then there's other days we have to have someone to fight for us. The secret to continued victory is to recognize what day it is. Ooh. What day is it? Is this the day that I fight for George spiritually? Or is this the day that George fights for Bill? Is this the day that Bill fights for David? Or is this the day that David fights for Bill? See, some days I'm strong. Some days I'm on fire. Some days it seems like I'm on a mountaintop and I look like Samson standing up there on the hill and I'm carrying off the gates of the city. And then there's other days, I'm the Samson, and I find myself, my hair is cut, I've lost my power, and I'm grinding at the mill. Some days, I can fight for George. Other days, I don't have the strength, and I need George to fight for me. It never hurts to call for backup. If either one of these guys get a call, a domestic call, they get to the house, they're not going in until they call for backup. And listen to me, you and I have got to live at the place, Jay, that we're not ashamed to call for backup. I'm thankful for our new men's ministry. I'm thankful for that. I'm thankful for the encouragement. If you're not connected to the men's, whatever it is, Dave will be out. But just the words of encouragement that we're getting almost on a daily basis or every other day, just a prayer, a word of encouragement. If you're not getting those, make sure you get with Dave. Get connected, because I'm telling you right now, some days we need backup. The Bible says it like this. If a man walks by himself and he falls, who will be there to help him up? But the Bible says that if two agree together and they walk together and the one falls, the other will be there to help them up. The girlfriends team met on Saturday morning. And from everything, a little bit I was told, the first 45 minutes, it was just being there for one another. It was just loving one another. Because guess what? Sometimes when it rains naturally, we get heads up. Very seldom do we ever get a heads up when it rains spiritually or in the natural when it rains upon us and things don't go the way we want them to go. Very seldom do we get a heads up. Sometimes we're blindsided. We don't have to do life by ourselves. 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 9 and 10 in the Message translation. David went, he and the 600 men with him. They arrived at the brook of Besor, where some of them dropped out. David and 400 men kept up the pursuit. Everybody say pursuit. But 200 of them were too fatigued to cross over the brook, and they stayed there. 600 men. But when they got to the brook, 200 of them said, I just can't go any further. David said, stay here, rest. The 400 went into battle. But when you read that whole chapter, guess what you find out? Even though 400 went into battle, 200 of them did not go. They won the battle, and they all got to be a part of what was taken. Every one of them were paid. The 400 that fought and the 200 that didn't fight. Some days, you may not feel like fighting, but somebody will be there to fight for you. Galatians 6 and 2 in the King James, the Bible says, bear ye one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ. Bear ye one another's burdens. Victory in spiritual battles requires community and carrying each other's burdens. Some days you need a call for backup, and other days you are the backup. This is God's design to keep us from isolation. This is God's design to keep us from isolation. Nowhere in the scriptures do you find God's people prospering and being blessed when they are isolated. Bear ye one another's burdens. When I prayed for Ray a few moments ago, in his ear, I said, Ray, do you have my cell phone number? My personal number? He said, yes, sir. I said, 24 hours a day, if you ever need me, all you have to do is call. If you're lonely, if you're scared, if you're hurting, if you don't know which way to go, all you have to do is call. Winter, summer, spring, or fall, all you got to do is call. The song says, and I'll be there. Yes, I will. Let's all stand. You that are watching online, God never intended for you to live in isolation. We need one another. Every one of us need one another. You cannot make it by yourself. Father, I love you and I thank you. Your word is so real. Father, thank you for letting me know it's okay for me not to bat 100 every day or 1,000 every day. Thank you for letting me know that I don't have to be on the mountain every day. That some days I'm going to be hit. I'm going to be hit hard. Some days the devil is going to punch me in my gut, and it's going to feel like that I have no wind left on the inside of me. Some days it's going to feel like I'm just in this world by myself. Thank you for letting me know it's okay to call for backup. It's okay to call for backup.